10,000 dudes to keep y'all enthused. You better keep it tuned. Uh-huh. Only place to be for the controversy. If you really wanna see who make your moves, stay locked. This is your entertainment spot. All the things you wanna hear, and a couple you might not. But you guaranteed to be on the edge of your seat. Take it from me, Mike Drop Show with Bobby D. Find it on Ustream.tv.
So
now,
here we go.
Here we go.
Tell your phone.
Let them know.
Tune in, it's the Mike Drop Show.
Mike Drop.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Tell your phone.
Let them know.
Tune in, it's the Mike Drop Show.
Mike Drop.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you out to the Mic Drop Show. Finally, this is Mic Drop, where we do not keep our ears to the street. We drop the mic on it. I'd like to thank everybody for being patient. One thing different about this show is you probably saw last week, this is live TV, which means everything that happened here is completely and totally live. What you see in your background right now is City of Cincinnati. Looking at the traffic, you know, around the region. Pretty nice day out. Looking at 39 degrees right about now. 54 with a high of 54. And later on, the low is going to be 44, which means it's not going to be any colder than this the whole day, which I am 100% okay with that. We had a lot of big things going on in Cincinnati this week. One of the first and foremost, we had a casino opening. I had my homeboy down there. DJ Vader was giving them that heat down there at the casino, representing all of the cool kids, not only here, but all across the world. So we definitely appreciate him. That's a super good look for the city. I haven't had a chance to go. Hopefully later today I do get my chance to go check out that casino downtown. I think that's a really, really, really good look for the city, man. Hopefully that'll bring, I know it's already brought some jobs. I don't know how they're going to work on that traffic thing, but besides that, everything looks cool. One of the cool things about this show is we're going, like I said, it is live, which means that no matter what's happening, I will always do this show. If I'm on vacation, y'all be on vacation with me, no matter what. So we're going to get into some of this music, man. I'm going to shout it out first to my boy Replay Ran, one of the best videos I've seen this year. I had the privilege of being in it with him, so we're going to go to that now. Replay Ran, Quit, starring your boy Mike Drop, DB, a.k.a. Morning Space, a.k.a. Liberty Tax Services, Vader, Short Rock, whole WTFU crew, and a bunch of other guys, man. So we're going to get right into that video, and we're going to be right back, man, on the Mike Drop Show. Let's go, y'all.
I done damn near broke my alarm clock, hitting the hell out of snooze this morning, cause that itis put me to sleep that one way. I woke myself up snoring, and plus I don't like my job no more. I swear that shit is boring. I think I need a vacation, bro. Go wake up somewhere foreign. I should go and catch a plane, but now I'm in my whip. I done drove halfway to work, look down, no badge, I'm yelling shit. Make it in this bitch late, there go Bob, he a snitch. If he tell on me today, swear he gon' get his fat ass kicked. I get to my desk and I log in to Facebook, that is. Turn Pandora on and I try to zone, but damn, here come nosy ass Liz. Like, good morning, Ran, what you doing? Did you read that last memo? You working on your expense report? Bitch, I'm trying to finish my demo. Every time she come around, I gotta minimize my window. She like to talk too much. Oh, big eyed, have I always trying to see what I'm into? This place is making me mental. You know that show Snap? Well, I'm finto. I'm feeling local, about to go postal. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that it's time to go. So I
quit.
You can have your job, motherfucker. I
quit.
You can keep this shit, I swear.
I quit.
You can have your job, motherfucker. I
quit.
Put it on my mama, you can have your bag.
I'm not your bitch.
And your parking pass.
I'm not your bitch.
You can have your bag.
I'm not your bitch.
And your parking pass.
I'm not your bitch.
bitch. Cause I'm out this bitch, I'm out this bitch. I'm out this bitch. I really don't know what they smiling for, cause my check is a joke. They talking more work for the same pay, like I don't know why I'm getting stroke. Got me sitting in these long ass meetings and they won't stop talking while I'm standing at the door. Go 1 minute past my clock out time, I'ma grab my shit and go. Promoted Lisa to a manager, how the hell she dumb as a rock? Guess you really can't get ahead if you use your head on the boss's crotch. Look at my boss, old goofy ass dude. I know he was a nerd in school, should put him on blast, cause I seen him on Liberty fucking with them prostitutes. Tired of his corny ass jokes, I don't wanna do this fake laugh no more. Man, his voice is irritating, I just wanna sock him in his throat. Oh yeah, and who the hell went in my desk and ate my last bag of chips? I'ma have security run that tape back, and when I find out I'm gon' flip. Man, I should've listened to my mama, went to law school and got rich, all for suing corporations, but nope, I'm doing this shit. Man, this place is making me mental. You know that show Snap, well I'm finto. Dog, I'm feeling Lopez about to go post, so I'm pretty sure that it's time to go. So I'm
going to enjoy the company of all of these zeros. Bringing home the bacon, gotta feed the fam, cause these Hunger Games are a no-no. So going pro.
Hey man, I got shit. This part off, man.
Who told you to take that out?
Oh man, we just.
We working on this.
What the fuck is this, man?
What's good?
What's good?
What's up, man?
You know where the fuck I'm from, nigga?
Man, look, man. We circumcised your distributor cap, man. So it's perpendicular with your axles, play, boy.
What the
boy.
Fuck is that, man?
It's your vacuum cleaner.
My vacuum cleaner.
Hey, y'all.
Yeah.
Man, I quit. I'm out this bitch.
What the fuck?
Fuck yeah, I'm for real. Let's go.
Shit, I quit.
What am I supposed to do with this?
What? We got problems? We got problems up here? Cop?
Job, motherfucker, I
quit.
You can keep this shit, I swear, I
quit.
You can have your job, motherfucker, I
quit.
Put it on my mama, you can have your bag and your parking pass. You can have your bag and your parking pass. Cause I
quit.
I'm out this bitch, I'm out this bitch.
Quit.
I'm out this bitch.
Rolling on the road with nothing to do.
Never could I face it. Adversity, I hate it. Music is outdated. New music that I'm making. Niggas always hating on the music that I'm making. Yo, shit is nice, psych, nah. Like a kid that's playing. Always complaining. I could never be famous. Instead, appreciating all the songs that I created. Moving people out my way. Remember every move I make. Sorry to all my fans if you feel I have no faith. Would you cry if I die? Fuck it, I'll die today. Nobody wrote for me for anything that I had to say. AMO is back again, and I hope he's here to stay. Rolling on the road, eyes closed, but my mind is open. Still going strong, even though that my life is broken. Yeah, but I'm thankful. I'm trying. But I'm crying. I'm dying. I'm lying. I'm flying. But if I fly and fly away, just wait.
Check me out, 7617 Bread and Roll. Lando's Old School Happy Hour, the liveliest daytime party anywhere.
We back, ladies and gentlemen. It is me, Mike Drop. So most of y'all know the most popular thing that's pretty much going on Facebook right now is the anonymous post. So what we're going to do is every Saturday try to have the best or one of the best ones that we can that we have for Saturday, because I know that's one of you guys' favorite things. It's one of my favorite things too. It's gave me the opportunity to be able to help a lot of people through problems, issues they may have, and just get another voice. So if you're not familiar with it, please go on the Mike Drop Show fan page on Facebook. I'm going to read one now, and this post will go up immediately after I read it off. Okay, so we are going into anonymous post, ladies and gentlemen. And here it reads just like this. For years, people have tried to tell me that a friend of mine was interested in me. I would either get mad or laugh it off. I know that she is not the most girly female, and she can act like a little puppy at times. But I just thought she was being a loyal friend. That is, until recently. She texted me and asked for a picture of my vagina. I ignored the text, thinking that she sent it to me by mistake. Then I was at her house last night having a few drinks, and she found her way in between my legs. I must admit, she is damn good at what she does. I mean, damn good. This was my first experience with a woman, and I do not want to continue my friendship with her, nor do I want to date her. But I want to be able to call upon her services from time to time. What do I do? Am I wrong? Man, oh man, Facebook. Excuse me, Ustream, whoever, internet world. That's going right up right as we speak right now. Man, I don't know what to tell you, for real. I mean, if you liked it, I guess, I ain't mad at you. You know what I mean? Hey, what can I say? You went over your friend's house, and somehow she found a way in between your legs, and I guess it's pretty much history from there. I got nothing on that one. I mean, if you liked it, I mean, enjoy yourself, I guess. I don't know. But look, man, while y'all marinate on that, man, go to the Mic Drop Show right now on my Facebook fan page, and you can comment and give this young lady any type of advice you want to give her. We're going to play a couple videos, but up next, we're going to get into the most controversial topic that's been blazing everywhere, and I'm talking about this MTV Top MCs list, the hottest MCs list. Now, make sure y'all pay attention to exactly what I'm talking about, the hottest MCs. Not necessarily the best or the one who had the hottest lyrics or who had the best career. This is right now the hottest MCs, all right? Live on the Mic Drop Show, man. It's me, Mic Drop. We're going to get into some more videos. I'm going to check out my man Showtime with Breathing. And then my boy BJ Bowers with Smoking. Here live on the Mic Drop Show. Let's go, man.
Hey, yo, I used to have heavy thoughts to push away. Look at me now, stretched out, and it's too late. My stomach and my back hurting, and there's blood on the floor. That's what I get for sitting with my back to the door. It all started sitting back in this lazy boy. Thinking to myself, Don, you so lazy, boy. You could be in a 600 sitting lazy, boy. In the background, I'm listening to Bone and Biggie. Then I just said, fuck it, start watching New Jack City. Now my thoughts getting gritty, and thoughts getting witty. Like, fuck it, I could do it, I could milk this city. But first I need some niggas that's gon' be down with me, that'll hold a pound with me, bust off rounds with me. If we got knocked, say fuck it, do the time with me. If push come to shove, he be down to die with me. Take the game in blood, walk these footsteps with me. Then I thought of one nigga, so I made a call, asking one question, do you want some or all? He answered all. So I made another phone call to my uncle in Atlanta, like, uncle, I need dough. It's a drought up here and I need some dro. Hopped on the Greyhound and came back with pounds. Got three scot free, so it's profit now. I'm focused now, whole team eating now. Went from the bus line to whipping V-dots now. Replaced the car roofs with the sun and the clouds. Shit, as time went on, my team got stronger. My dough got longer and my problems got smaller. On top of that, man, I had me a daughter. And for my seed, any of these niggas I would slaughter. But the streets is watching, hearing bits and pieces of conversations. There's no room for mistakes. They knowing I'm eating it, ain't no deceiving it. Leave the game alone in my mind, I keep repeating it. But I got word, it's a crew from out of town that's running around screaming, get down or lay down. But long as them little fucks don't touch my blocks, they cool. They don't want to strap up and come act the fool. The next day, didn't even sleep in my new bed. I woke up where I started in my lazy boy chair. It's 8 o'clock, gotta get shorty to daycare. And then I call my right hand man like, yo, this the plan. I'm dropping shorty at the spot, won't you meet me there? We hooked up in politics, know how to solve this shit. Like, stop before it started, just wait a bit. Then he said, wait a bit, and my cell phone rung, sounding all hysterical. It's my baby mom's. I'm trying to get the girl to speak cool and calm. She told me that she at the daycare, the baby ain't there. I told her, hold the fuck on, I'll be right there. Got to the spot and found out somebody named Grandpa sound my daughter out about 2 o'clock. 5 minutes later, my phone rung again. Say we need 100,000 if you want your kid. said, I said, cool. Whatever it is you want me to do, just don't do nothing stupid, cause you know how I do. He say, rule number one, no twos. Number two, no Jakes. Number three, be by yourself at the place. I told him one rule, meet me in the public field. I ain't stupid, I know the deal. You ain't gonna have me tied up like I'm Copperfield. Your whole team full of fags, probably Copperfield. He gave a laugh. Then I heard a click, click, a pause and a blast. He say, a little to the left would've bent her ass. Nah, this ain't no movie big time, this some real life shit. So bring the money to the mall if you want your bitch, click. I can't perp right now, I'm feeling nervous. Daughter caught up in this shit, she don't deserve this. I went and got the money out the stash box and told my nigga, meet me at the diner at 6 o'clock. I'm sitting daydreaming, looking out the window. I saw his truck pop up through the window. I seen him walk, put out his last piece of endo. He came to the table like, bruh, switch me spots. You don't need to be by the window case they throwing shots.
Hard to breathe now, but there's nowhere in my lungs.
So right now, I'm sitting with my back to the door, and it's feeling kinda funny, never did this before. But I'm thinking I might, my nigga holding the four. Then he starts saying shit I ain't never heard before, like I'm eating too much, not sharing the wealth. Then I heard the door close, so I turned around calm. It's this group of niggas with my baby moms. I asked her, so this the type of shit y'all on? You mean to tell me my C wasn't going on along? So I looked in his face like, you son of a bitch. I reached for my waist, tried to grab the fifth. See, I used to have heavy thoughts of pushing weight, but look at me now, stretched out, and it's too late. My stomach and my back hurting, and there's blood on the floor. That's what I get for sitting with my back to the door. Now my breather getting low, and my thoughts is racing. Fingers moving on their own, and it's fear I taste it. Tears streaming down my face, cause it's death I'm facing. It's death I'm facing.
Trying hard to breathe now, but there's nowhere in my lungs. Trying hard to breathe now, but there's nowhere in my lungs.
That's the type of chick you make love to. You laughing, I'm dead ass. She's smoking. And I don't just mean any kind of smoking, I mean medical marijuana smoking. Or at least what they call medical marijuana. You know, moms, I just wanna take you to the face one time. Who next?
Shot is so hot, you kill a shit. Cold blood, homicide, suicide. Don't doze up when I roll up, roll up, roll up, hide it. I want you so bad, I can't hide it. Your mama should've named you Mary or something. Give you something, and you're smoking. Smoking like the barrel of a gun just fired. You are smoking like the roof, baby, it's on fire. Whenever I get round you, I get higher. Girl, I can't wait to catch contact. I just can't wait to catch contact. Okay, so I contact her, she was like, what's up? I was like, come through, she was like, bet. Damn, you got here quick, but you fly jet. I know you a freak, why you acting like that? Like a nigga ain't got a check, girl, throw it back. Your mama should've named you Keisha or something, cause you smoking hot, hot like you stolen. I'm talking all eyes on high on the open. Bust it open, get it wet like an ocean. Give me all your love.
Hey, this motherfucker stick up, get on.
Until it ain't no more left to give.
Everything.
Girl, you're the best thing smoking. There ain't nothing better. Ain't nobody better. Better, you're smoking. Girl, I can't wait to catch contact. I just can't wait to catch contact. Smoking like the barrel of a gun just fire.
Just fire.
Smoking like the roof, baby, it's on fire.
It's on fire.
Whenever I get round you, I get higher. Girl, I can't wait to catch contact. I just can't wait to catch contact.
I gotta do something crazy or something, get her attention, and then it's a wrap from there.
I could take, first you gotta make eye contact.
Just had to come over here and tell you that. Oh yeah, I'm high.
That's just me though. Music industry.
You smoking
burglar,
whatever the fuck your name is.
You did
Keisha, I read. But you smoking, baby. You smoking. See ya.
I cannot keep sleeping alone at night. I'm love sick. I can't keep doing it. You think I'm fucking love sick?
I just gotta get some love. If I'm spending enough time around you, then I need to be around you. I get love sick.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Before we get into anything, I want to do a little bit of housekeeping, excuse me. First, I want to give a really big shout out, rest in peace, to my man Paul Bearer. He passed away on March 5th. If you guys do not know who this is basically the manager to The Undertaker, which is one of the biggest wrestling phenoms ever. So if you were ever a wrestling fan and you remember The Undertaker, rest in peace to Mr. Paul Bearer. Now, a little more housekeeping. We also want to give a big shout out, and today is actually the anniversary of my man, 50 grand and all, the notorious B.I.G., better known as Biggie, or Frank White. Shout out to you, man. And we had to get all of that done before we got into the next segment, which I'm going to talk about, which is this MTV list of the 10 hottest MCs right now in the game, okay? Now, I'm going to read this list off to you. There's some really funny things in here. I'm going to start off at number 10, which is Meek Mills. No problem there. Meek Mills doing his thing. I ain't hating. Number 9, Future. Number 8, A$AP Rocky. Again, really don't have a problem. Number 7, Kanye West. We gonna go back to Kanye West. It's because you know Kanye definitely had a problem with him being number 7. Big Sean at 6. I have no problem with that. And even Kanye had no problem with that. Number 5, Drake. Drake doing his thing. Drake just dropped that new single. Started from the bottom. Blazing everywhere right now. We got Nas at number 4. Now that's a little bit more suspect. I like Nas. We'll get back to that. Number 3, Rick Ross. You can't hate him. MMG is everywhere right now, so you really can't help hate Rick Ross. Number 2, 2 Chainz. I don't know if they made him number 2 because his name started with 2, or you know, I don't know. And number 1, we got my man Kendrick Lamar, Mr. Poetic Justice, Mr. Pull Up, Drink. Pass out, drink. Man, that's a lot of controversy. I'm going to tell y'all, personally, I cannot have Nas on this list, man. As much as I like Nas. We all know Nas. Nas is a phenomenal MC. He is one of the best MCs to ever bless a mic. Ever. You will never take that away from him. No matter what I say, no matter what nobody else does. But when I think of hot, I do not think of Nas. I have not heard a single from Nas. I have not heard him play on the radio. I'm in the club all the time. You won't hear none of Nas's music. Period. You just won't. And it doesn't mean that he's not good. It just means he really ain't hot. Now, do I like Nas? I mean, even when the problem I have with it is a lot of times when you get a bunch of people in a room who are quote-unquote hip-hop purists and all that stuff, they always want to get personal when you want to talk about Nas, like you're talking about, you know, one of their relatives or something. And even on MTV, when I read the thing, they basically started it off just like that. I'm gonna read a little part of it, and they talk about Nas. This is a quote from their webpage. You can look it up on MTV's site. Here's a little Hottest MC trivia. Despite being one of rap's most revered artists, Nas has never made a dent on a single Hottest list. Now, his album did go gold, The Life is Good, which was a damn good album, did go gold. But I personally, I just can't put him in hot. He ain't cracked nowhere in the billboards. His highest ranking was 90. I don't know how you get 90 and you in the number 4. You hotter than Drake? I mean, I ain't trying to be funny whether you like Drake or not. Drake is hot. Drake is blazing up, you know. Now, as you can imagine, a bunch of people, you know, more important than me, had a problem with the list, most notably Mr. Kanye West. So Kanye basically called into the radio show, and he had a little something to say, which is hilarious in true Kanye asshole fashion. I'm going to go ahead and play that for y'all now.
I couldn't believe it. Like, I mean, I gave Sway his first TV, man. He came over my crib in Newark, New Jersey. I was living in Newark, you know, doing beats for Jay and Beans and all them. I was getting a new TV, and I gave Sway his first TV. And really, I didn't really want to, like, even call to, like, even talk about the number 7 list. I just want to tell everybody I gave Sway his first TV, and he need to remember that.
Man, first of all, I find it completely hilarious that Kanye actually hung up the phone after that. I gave Sway his first TV. He need to remember that. Bye. I mean, damn, did they break up or something like that? So, one thing I got to give Sway credit for is he actually does admit that he did get his first TV from Kanye West. So, I want y'all to hear the story because the story was pretty funny too, man. We're going to get into Sway responding to Kanye West saying that he gave him his first TV.
My very first guess is the only television set to trend worldwide. Please welcome my first TV given to me by Kanye West. Back in 2001, Kanye West and I would hang out from time to time. He would come to MTV, and we talked about doing some business together, and he invited me to his house in Newark, New Jersey, to hear some beats. So I got a chance to hang out with Kanye, see his house, to hear some beats, and after we did the business, he started showing me around his house. Kanye, first of all, is one of the most talented visionaries we have in this business. So him inviting me to see his house, of course I did it. He walked me around from room to room. I saw his pool table. I saw his kitchen. I saw some other rooms. And at one point I had to use the bathroom. And I said, "Yay, yo, where's your bathroom at? Can you show me the bathroom?" And he walked me to the bathroom. He said, "There it is over there." And this is where we first met. When I opened the bathroom door, which was probably the size of a closet, the first thing I saw was this hunk of a TV sitting in Kanye West's sink. I thought it was abstract art. So I went ahead and used the bathroom while I watched the TV. And when I came out of the bathroom, I asked Ye, "Man, what's up with the TV in your sink?" And Ye responded to me, "Yo, dog, it's 36 inches. This TV is too small to put in my living room. It's embarrassing. So I hide it in my sink because the TV is embarrassing." Being from Oakland, I asked Kanye, "Well, what are you going to do with the TV? You going to throw it away?" He said, "Yep." I said, "No, you're not, homie. You grab one end of the TV, I'm going to grab the other." We took the TV to my car. I went home, and the rest is history.
Man, so that is the story of Sway's first TV outed by Kanye because he was mad because he was number 7 on this list, man. It's getting crazy, man. Y'all hit me up. Let me know what y'all think about this MTV list, where y'all think somebody should be. I'm going to tell y'all right now, y'all can keep the list as it is because I don't really care about the order as much as long as certain people in it. I got to take Nas off, and y'all got to put Wale on this list. I don't know how Wale does not make this list. He's been blazing. He weed MMG. To Rick Ross, I mean, and Meek Mill. I would arguably say he's probably hotter than Meek Mill right now. I mean, cut after cut after cut. He's been on, you know, from Dice Pineapples to everything. I gotta say, take Nas out, although he's an all-time great. Put Wale on that list, and I probably have no problems with this list, man. So we're going to get into some more videos. We got my boy Young Rome coming in with Blow Up. Then we got The Wake with Funeral Fresh, Bugs the Rocket, and Macho Means here on the Mic Drop Show.
Hold up, bitch, I'm about to
lifted about to blow up. Yeah. Rattling bottles, blow up. Drinking till they throw up. You know how we show out. Every time we show up. Bitch, I'm about to blow up. Why y'all hating on us? That shit ain't get your hoe fucked. Told her you ain't gotta buy a thing, girl, it's on us. Then she say, you know I got a man, but I'm like, so what? Doubt me if you won't, I'm just trying to get my dough up. Till a nigga dead, I'm about my bread like a coca. I've been in the game for a while, money coach us. No fake ice like stage fright, my wrist done got froze up.
Praise to Allah, I just cannot wear a rosary. Wild boy, what
the shy girl that's all over me. No cowboy stadium, it's cold and she doming me. Let it get hot, she bust it open. Boatload of animals that know it's shit. Ride till it's over with. I hit the mic, you know I put a disease on it. Hey, Matt Niff, give you what's up, a breeze on it. My bitch bad, she take my dick and do her thing on it. If I was lame, I'd have spent it all my cheese on it. J-O-E, Clark, Sprite lean on me. This the wick, just the case they would sleep on me. Love my this
overnight but daylight, but goddamn, a nigga made a pretty play, right? Broke my roll in, made that stage bright, did it with no pen, but yet I ain't tight. Pretty new, but I decked it out like I've been a owner. They throwing jabs, I laugh, nigga, I've been a broner. All I know is this mad boy, I've been a problem. That's why these niggas is mad, but fuck it. This is my 15 on this sweet 16. Got the voice of the year, why would I lip sing? I'm talking what I live, it's exactly what it seems. Might just do a 20 just to show them that it's mean. That's what they call me in the projects. This is for the fans that I'm still a see a road shit. This is for the niggas that be trying to sell a dope wet. And lamest terminology, boy, it's those jets. Anybody in the way, I give them cold flesh. I'ma be here for a while with a coat check. Yeah, I hope you niggas feeling broke, yeah. This the wet motherfuckers, but it's no rest. I'ma be here for a while with a coat check. That's right.
Studio Barbershop and Beauty Salon, located at 2915 Highland Avenue in Clifton. Make your appointment today.
2-2-1.
What's up, y'all? We back at the Mic Drop Show, and like I've told y'all before, man, this show is totally live, so everything that's happening at that very second we could get. So, I don't know if a lot of y'all have already heard about Chris Brown and that beef with Meek Mills. Earlier in the week, Chris Brown is doing too much, first of all. Earlier in the week, he at least squashed that beef with Meek Mills. Apparently, they met up at the club, shook hands, said it's all love, yada, yada, yada. But last night, he was in the club. Oh, Chris, man, what is you doing? I'm going to roll to the clip, man. He was in the club. We all know that him and Rihanna is back together. They've been at the Grammys and everywhere else shown together. We got Chris Brown last night. This is reported live from TMZ. Check this clip out, y'all. He off the hook.
Okay, so look, every guy in this building has said one female, right? But they you're not an insecure and you let her have fun with her friends, I applaud you. But you gotta say that one thing to her, and I made this up. Don't make me have to tell you again that that's my baby.
Yes, sir.
That's my baby. It's my girl. So you better not give it away. So every person in this building, if you got a bad bitch, you better say that to her, cause she might have a
happy birthday, Randy Bruce.
Let's go, turn up.
Happy birthday, Randy Bruce. Happy birthday, Randy.
Man, so apparently, if you have a bad bitch, you need to tell them that that is my pussy. Or if not, according to Chris Brown, she may fuck another nigga. I don't make this up, ladies and gentlemen. That happened last night at the club. Chris Brown is off the chains. But he did also say, if you got a bad bitch, you also do not need to beat her. So at least he has learned something. in these last couple of years being out on stage, man. Oh, man, that's funny. Hey, I can't make this stuff up, ladies and gentlemen. This stuff just happens. So, man, up next, we're going to get into another couple videos while I react to that video right there. We're going to get into Sexing You, man. But my name, I don't even know how to pronounce your man's name. Amari J. Really, really hot R&B artist, man. Hey, an R&B artist, would y'all please get some videos? I mean, I love rap music. I'm a hip-hop head. But, man, the people love that R&B too, man. So, I mean, yeah, hey, y'all need to get up on y'all game and get y'all videos. I can say right now, the rappers is killing y'all on them videos. Because when I asked, y'all had 100 of y'all send me stuff, say, hey, play my music, but y'all ain't got videos. So we're going to get into my man video. Y'all check it out. We'll be right back, man.
Yeah.
Okay, y'all, I want to welcome y'all back to the Mic Drop Show, man. Y'all make sure y'all check us out next Saturday at the main event. The Cool Kids, my partners, DJ Vader, Replay Ran, and, of course, myself, just doing it up, man, celebrating in all of the best high schools in the area and even the worst high schools in America So both of those, man, come out and rep your high school, man. We're doing it real big down there. Bring your dancing shoes. We're going to have a really, really good time, man. So one of the things I want to get into, man, is this whole Harlem Shake thing. It's been going crazy nuts, and I myself, I can say that I didn't like pretty much that it's called the Harlem Shake, but I did have to do a little more research for people who do not know what I'm talking about. I'll show you one of these Harlem Shake videos that is now popular by my boys, the Miami Heat. You know, they have one of the best ones out. Let's check it out.
Con los terroristas.
Harlem Shake.
So that was the Miami Heat version of the Harlem Shake videos that's been going on all across pretty much the world. And again, some people weren't happy. So after seeing this, Harlem did have a response, and y'all knew Harlem was going to respond. Let's take a look at that.
Oh, oh my God. Oh, what? What the hell is this?
What?
That's weird. That's weird.
What are they doing?
I mean, interesting. I just really don't think it's closely related to the original Harlem Shake.
Yeah, I know the Harlem Shake, but that ain't the Harlem Shake.
No, that's not the Harlem Shake.
It looks way different.
Yeah, it doesn't look like the original Harlem Shake. Yeah.
But it's not the Harlem Shake, like, at all.
That's not the shake, me? Oh, no good.
That's not it.
This is not what the Harlem Shake is at all.
Yeah, that's just kind of bugged out. That's definitely not the Harlem Shake.
That's not the Harlem Shake at all. That's humping, and that's not the Harlem Shake.
They ain't not Harlem.
They're dry humping air.
I think they're misinformed. Not,
yeah. They look like they just smoked some dust.
I feel like they're trying to disrespect us.
They didn't live in Harlem. They don't come from Harlem. They come from
a
strange planet.
It's making us look bad. It's an absolute mockery of what it was, because there's actually a sense of rhythm that goes along with it.
They just think, oh, you just moved the upper part of your body.
They're playing around with it, like, you're not taking it serious, but it really is.
People making a fool of themselves, rubbing on each other, but not the Harlem Shake.
It's actually an art form, a dance art form that doesn't have the respect that it should deserve.
So that was basically the response of Harlem. When they seen it, they pretty much were confused because that wasn't a Harlem Shake. Now, what I really, I mean, you knew they was going to get offended. You know, I ain't trying to be funny, but y'all know black folks get offended about anything, but we ain't going to go into that. But what I really, really love is that we actually did get to see the real and the original Harlem Shake, made popular by people like Diddy. Even Dave Chappelle used to do the little Harlem Shake on the shows, you know. So I want y'all to check it out so y'all can know what the real, real Harlem Shake actually looks out.
Con los terroristas.
Is that Kid DeWiz?
Shake to this, yeah, 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 shake to this, yeah
show you how to do this, son.
So that was the real Harlem Shake from people from Harlem. Represent, man. Shout out to all the kids doing something constructive. Gotta give love to that, man. Gotta give love to that. So up next, man, one of my favorite segments. We all know that a lot of times we as minorities get pigeonholed and we're only shown in one certain light. So a lot of the images that you get of people of color, especially black people, are those that are negative. And it's not that we want to see, that I even want to see a lot of negativity on news. I would just like to see it a little bit more fairly distributed. So because of that, now that I have my medium and I can talk to the world, I'm going to do that because, damn it, it's my show. So in this next segment here, we got, thanks, sweet baby Jesus, this fool is not black. Because all of y'all know, every once in a while, y'all read a story and y'all say, sweet baby Jesus, I hope this fool is not black. So today, into this prestigious realm of stupidity, I want to call to a teacher. I don't know how to say her first name, Miss Anderson. She's a teacher in Norway who thought it was a good idea to have her students taste her blood. As the story goes, she brought in a vial of her blood. She put it on a plate. The kids then put their fingers in it. After they put their fingers in it, they asked the teacher, how do I get this off of my finger? Her response was to say, was to put her finger in her mouth, and then she just licked it off. I didn't wash my hands. Anyway, thank you for not being black. We appreciate idiots like you. So thank you. Hey, man, we're getting ready to wrap up here on the Mic Drop Show. Like I said, man, this show is different than a lot of shows out. This is completely and totally live. As y'all saw last week, Ustream, the whole thing just crashed on me right before I was going to air my show. So I appreciate a lot of y'all tuning in this week. All the shout-outs I'm getting on Twitter as well as on Facebook about the show, all the artists who submitted videos. More artists, please submit videos. I appreciate that. One of the things that kind of had me down last week when everything did crash, I couldn't get that upset because it was the whole site. It wasn't just something on my end, something I couldn't control. Last week was my son's birthday, so I want to wish my son another very happy birthday and a very belated birthday. It's very important that we take, as fathers, take part in our child's lives. I just want to give a special shout out to my son on his birthday with a special clip dedicated to him. I love you. Daddy always gonna love you. Damn. You almost got Mic Drop the Crown TV. I almost did my Jerry Maguire. Anyway, I also want to give a shout out to all of the people, all my sponsors, Lando's Old School Happy Hour, More Than Space, as well as the studio barbershop. He's also got my man DB, got the the tax service also on Liberty. I want to give a shout out to the oh so lovely people at BRA. They got a lot of things working with the Mic Drop Show, man. We're going to do some contests, give away some things. They're really doing it big over there. I appreciate it. Thank y'all for tuning in, man. We're going to sign out. Happy birthday, X. Daddy loves you. Peace out, y'all. It's the Mic Drop. Perfectly than to have a world party.